Study of different factors affecting T-bolt failure of band clamp. Abstract: this paper describes study of hydrogen embrittlement and thread form of T-bolt of the band clamp. Hydrogen embrittlement is the very critical phenomenon which can cause the catastrophic failure of the bolt. Threads are available in various forms. The assembly of different bolt and nut having different thread forms can cause interference effect which can cause the failure of bolt. In this paper, hydrogen embrittlement phenomenon, mechanism, and different testing method are discussed, and compatibility of UN and UNJ thread forms are examined by CATIA modeling. Keywords: hydrogen embrittlement, thread grade, UN, UNJ, interference. Introduction. Mechanical joints are part of machine which are used to connect one or more components to each other. Mechanical joints may be permanent or temporary type as per requirement of the machine/part. Mechanical joints are designed in such a way that it can allow the restrict moment between the two or more parts in one or more directions. Pin joint, ball joint, knuckle joint, cotter joint, welded joint, bolted joint, etc. are some of types of the mechanical joints. The band clamp is used for joining two parts by Marman joint or assembling the any part on another cylindrical part. The band clamps consists of circular strap with bolt assembled in it. Tension is provided on the T-bolt by means of nut which provides force that holds the ends together. T-bolt band clamps are specially designed clamps to provide connections without leaks. They are mainly used to form butt joints. T-bolt band clamps are used for multiple applications like automobile, heavy truck, duct connection, irrigation, railway, tractor, pneumatic connections, etc. Different parameters can be responsible for the failure of T-bolt. These parameters should be examined properly to predict the failure mode of T-bolt. Some of these are listed below. Failure caused due to any of these factors can lead to heavy loss of the parts. To predict and prevent the failure of the bolt, it is necessary to study the different failure modes and correct them before causing any heavy losses. In further discussion, effect of hydrogen embrittlement, thread grade is briefed. Hydrogen embrittlement is the failure process which takes place in the presence of hydrogen in metal and residual or applied tensile stresses on part. Hydrogen is the lightest element in the periodic table, and at ambient pressure and temperature it is a gas with two atoms, H2. In air, the hydrogen content is very low, but water contains 11% hydrogen and the Earth's crust contains 0.14% hydrogen, mostly as crystalline water, but also as oil and hydrocarbons. This hydrogen present in the environment can react with metal and form hydrogen embrittlement. Hydrogen can also enter into the material lattice during various manufacturing processes like hydrogen phosphating, pickling, electroplating, casting, carbonizing, surface cleaning, electrochemical machining, welding, hot roll forming, heat treatments, etc. 1. Mechanisms. Many scientists propose different mechanisms for the hydrogen embrittlement. The researchers are still working on it. Variety of mechanisms can cause the hydrogen embrittlement, like hydride formation and fracture, hydrogen enhanced decohesion, hydrogen enhanced localized plasticity. Hydride formation and fracture. This mechanism is based on the formation and fracture of hydrides at the crack tip formed in the material. This is the series of repeated process involving I. hydrogen diffusion ahead of the crack tip at the high hydrostatic stress region. 2. Nucleation and growth of hydride phase. 3. Cleavage formation in hydride. 4. Crack arrest at hydride matrix interface. Hydride mechanism requires some favorable conditions to occur, such as temperature and strain rate, such that the hydrogen has sufficient time to diffuse in the metal and temperature where hydride phase is stable. Hydrogen enhanced decohesion, HEDE. A hydrogen is the first element of the periodic table and lightest amongst all. Atomic number of hydrogen is 1 and electronic configuration is 1s1, iron have atomic number 26 and electronic configuration is Ar4s2 3d6. When the hydrogen comes in the contact with iron in the metal, it donates its electron to the unfilled 3d shell of iron. Due to this donation, the interatomic bond in the irons gets weak. Decohesion is weakening of the interatomic, which results in the sequential tensile separation of the atoms when a critical crack tip opening displacement, CTOD, is reached. Decohesion at grain boundaries occurs ahead of crack tip due to trapped hydrogen and impurities at sites, which results in weakening of bond. Hydrogen-enhanced localized plasticity, HELP, this mechanism states that speed of dislocation enhances near the crack tip due to the accumulation of the hydrogen. Dislocation behaves as carrier of plastic deformation in the metal lattice. Local dislocation movement is possible at relatively low tensile stress due to the presence of hydrogen. Active energy and activation area required for the location can be decreased by the effect of hydrogen. Factors affecting hydrogen embrittlement. A. The various material properties and external factors can vary the intensity of the hydrogen embrittlement. Factors affecting the hydrogen embrittlement in the materials are listed below. Hardness. Material having hardness more than 32 HRC is more susceptible to hydrogen embrittlement. Temperature. He gradually diminishes when the temperature is higher than 100 degrees C, which increases the susceptibility of hydrogen embrittlement cracking in metal. Different techniques and tools to measure hydrogen embrittlement. Temperature desorption spectroscopy. This measures the amount of desorbed hydrogen in the material by controlled and limited heating. When the heat is supplied to the material, then the hydrogen absorbs the thermal energy and release itself. The quantity of hydrogen is measured by quadrupole mass spectroscopy. 1. Microstructural analysis. Microstructural analysis plays an important role in the evaluation of hydrogen embrittlement susceptibility of a material and alloy. Scanning electron microscopy, SEM, and transmission electron microscopy, TEM, are analytical technique for determining the internal microstructure of a material and effect of presence of hydrogen in microstructure and characteristic of material. 1. Hydrogen microprint technique. This technique is used to know the path of diffusible hydrogen in metal. This technique can be applied to different materials such as low-carbon steel, high-strength steel and austenite steel. In this process, the surface of hydrogen-charged material is covered with thin layer of AgBr gel. After the reaction, metallic form of silver ion has created and leaves a track where hydrogen contact happened. Silver particles are present on this location and the excess unreacted gel is take off from that place. SEM examination of the sample is carried where the silver is present. 1. Crystal structure. Rates of hydrogen diffusion in pure metals at ambient temperatures depend especially on the crystal structure, with hydrogen diffusion coefficients, D, generally 4 to 5 orders of magnitude higher for body-centered cubic, BCC, metals compared with face-centered cubic, FCC, and hexagonal close-packed, HCP, metals at 20 degrees C. Hydrogen concentration. As hydrogen concentration increases in the metal lattice or at the grain boundaries, the pressure exerted by it increases. This test gives the testing method for various mechanical properties like tensile properties, hardness. It also gives the embrittlement testing method by using washer, hardened plate, and wedge. F1624. This test method gives the threshold stress value of the steel by using incremental step loading method. By keeping the stress value below threshold stress value, embrittlement can be avoided. F519-18. This test method gives acceptance criteria for coating and plating processes that can cause hydrogen embrittlement in steels. Subsequent exposure to chemicals encountered in service environments, such as fluids, cleaning treatments, or maintenance chemicals that come in contact with the plated/coated or bare surface of the steel, can also be evaluated by this test. G3801. In this method, the specimen is kept in the desired environmental condition under stress and the timing of failure is calculated. This gives the predicted serviceability period for the specimen. G41. This test method gives the information about susceptibility of material to the corrosion cracking when the material is exposed to salt environment. The thickness of plate was maintained in such a way that, after installation and tightening, A minimum of 3 full threads of the test fastener was in the grip. Wedge was of hardness 45 HRC, thickness equal to 1/2 the nominal fastener diameter, i.e. 0.125 inch, and angle should be 6a degree. The T-bolt was tensioned to 75% of their specified minimum ultimate tensile strength. The assembly kept in this tightened state for not less than 48 h, after which the test fastener was visually examined for embrittlement-induced failure, such as missing head. The joint was then disassembled, and the test fastener visually examined using a 2.4x power magnificatin for evidence of embrittlement failure, such as transverse cracks in the shank, threads or at the junction of head to shank. Thread form. Thread structure convert the rotational motion of the nut to the linear motion. Threads of the bolts holds the nut on the bolt by providing required friction between them. Basic terminology of thread is described by thread pitch, lead, minor diameter, major diameter, root radius, addendum, dedendum, helix angle, lead angle, flank angle, axial thickness. Threads are mainly differentiated due to different thread grades, thread forms, thread fits. Thread form determines the way in which the male and females fits together. Unified thread standards, UTS, is dominated thread fits. UN, UNR, and UNJ are different thread form standards used in UTS. Above standard only differ in the number of threads per inch. Coarse have least number of threads per inch and extra fine have largest number as compared to others. Conclusion. Hydrogen embrittlement can cause catastrophic failure in the bolt. Use of different preventative measure and testing methods can reduce this risk. The T-bolt tested by ASTM F606-F606M standard for hydrogen embrittlement passed the test. Bolt of UNJ thread form assembled with nut of UN thread form causes the interference problem. Hence assembly of them should be avoided.